I say, praise the Lord. Inu mi dun wipe mo rojo oni. Inu mi dun wipe oni soju mi. Congratulations, oremo worewa. Oremo worewa.
Oremo worewa.
Congratulations, oremo worewa. Congratulations, oremo worewa. Inu mi dun wipe mo rojo oni. Ayo mi dun sori oni soju mi.
Congratulations, oremo worewa.
Oremo wa sope. Praise the Lord. Ope wa Yoshi Tewaba. Oh Lord, our heavenly host, today is the last Sunday of this year. You give every one of us the grace to worship on the first Sunday of this year. And today, you count us worthy again to be in your presence. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Throughout the year, many waters have passed through the bridge. Turbulent winds has already across the old world. But you can't trust worthy to be on this land. It is by your grace. Lord, accept our thanks.
Amen.
As we are going to wars, let your wars be a light to our darkness in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It is only by your power that our darkness can turn into light.
Amen.
And our trouble can be turned into praises. Lord, do it for us. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Before I move forward, I would like us to sing this song. Olorun betel eniti. O n bo awon ti re. Eni to mu awon baba wa la ojo aye won ja. Olorun betel eniti o n bo awon ti re. Eni to mu awon baba wa la ojo aye won ja. Olorun betel eniti o n bo awon ti. Eni to mu awon baba wa la eni to mo wa baba wa la lojo aye waja ojo aye waja amu eje ati ebe wa amu eje ate be wa iwaju tere wa yi waju te olorun awon baba wa olorun wa baba wa ma je olorun wa ma je olorun wa ninu idamu aye yi ninu eda Ajoju ipa wa ajo ewe ipa wa o wa ni ounje ojo wa fun wa ni ounje ojo ataso to ye wa ta yewa na ojiji ye re bo wa yunwa o jiye re bo ti ta jo wa o pe te ta jo wa a ti ni ibupe baba wa a te le bo we baba ọkàn wa ó sinmi ọwà ó sinmi irú ìbìkún bí èyí èrò egbògun bí la ń bèrè lọ́wọ́ rẹ àmì ìlọ́wọ́ ìwọ jẹ́ ọlọ́run wa ìwọ yóò jẹ ọlọ́run wa àti ilé wa láìlá tí ìwé wa láìlá àmì ọlọ́run Bethel yóò máa bójútó wa. Ọlọ́run Bethel kò ní fi wá sílẹ̀, òun náà ló ti fún wa ní agbára láti wákàtí ọ̀wọ̀ yìí lọ láti wọ ọkọ̀ tuntun náà tó kú bí wákàtí 72 ó dé díẹ̀ ní agbára ọlọ́run gbogbo alájọ wọ ọkọ̀ náà. Kí ògùn ọlọ́run kó wà nínú ayé wa. Ẹ jẹ́ ká jókòó. Today the last Sunday of the year 2013. Every one of us have reasons to honor and praise God. For our God is good. January to December is a journey you will agree that is full of various fearful and dreaded happenings. And God in His majesty enable us to worship with Him today to say goodbye to year 2013. With grace and honor, Lord, we give you glory and honor. Last Sunday, the pastor led us to a service of thanksgiving, which the Lord opened the window of heaven to accept our thanksgiving. Let me mention some of the sermons you have privilege to hear on this mountain, which I hope you gain a lot from the teachings from the anointed men of God. On March 24, the topic of the sermon was God in you, for that faith to work. Matthew 21, verse 2 was the text by Pastor Ogunyemi. On April 7, 2013, Holy Spirit, the promise of God. The text was Romans 10, verse 14, by Pastor Ogunyemi. Transformation will lead to manifestation was the main topic. On April 14, 2013, sinners will entice you. Don't consent. Proverbs 1, verse 8. By Pastor Odelide. This sermon was directed to all our youths because they are in the world. We have friends. We try to entice them with evil things and it will take them out of the way. Therefore, the parents have a lot to do so that friends will never entice them to go out of the way. In Jesus' name, God will be with them. On May 26, 2010, this is a great service for what God has done for this church. We all are witness to the great day because God is good in our lives. And God has done marvelously well. Today, I will refresh your memory about what we heard from Pastor Yemi on this day. The main topic he said was Nibo ni kin ti bere.
Nibo ni kin ti bere. He was trying to go through all what he has gone through and how God eventually comes to his aid. He narrated with pain and joy, for God gave him the glory to be here on this mountain on that very day to give thanks to God who has brought him back after almost 4 years of sojourn in Nigeria. Nibo Labati Bere was the main topic, and he ended with special prayer, and the prayer was Mumi kuro leniyan lasan. Ni agbara Olorun, Olorun a mu ikuro ninu eniyan lasan. E ni je eniyan lasan. Bi eliyan ti e nfe ke je eniyan lasan. E o ni je eniyan lasan. Oluwa ko wa pelu wa. June 9, 2013. Don't let anyone despise thy youth. 1 Timothy 4:12. Also directed to our youth by Pastor Odenide. The Lord is always around. It is for us parents to teach our children in the right way, so that nobody can despise their youth. If they are making progress, enemy will surely rise against them to discourage them. So God will be with all our youths, and will be a successful leaders of tomorrow. Don't let anyone despise thy youth. On June 23rd this year, moving from story to glory, 1 Samuel 23:14 by Pastor Yemi Ayeni. By the grace of God, whatever may be your story, you will move to glory. Whatever may be your story, you will move to glory in Jesus' name. And on July 14, bitterness is not an option. Psalm 118:13 by Pastor Yemi Ayeni. Bitterness against your enemy is not the solution. The solution is to move closer to God. And by the grace of God, you will conquer your enemy in any area they will come across you. So bitterness shouldn't be an option. On August 21st, where are your accusers? Where are your accusers? John 8:10 by Pastor Anujo. Every one of us has an accuser. That is why Jesus Christ told us why he was going, that he will send the Holy Spirit to be your lawyer, your advocate. When people are in front of God or anybody or in before the law to accuse you of an offense you don't know, the Holy Spirit will rise to defend you. Where are your accusers? August 23rd this year, if you are willing and obedient, if you are willing and obedient, you know what the reward? You will eat the fruit of the land. Isaiah 1:19 by Pastor Oguyemi. On September 6th this year, how you can fear from God, how you can hear from God, how you can hear the voice of God. God speaks to everybody. The problem is, how can you know that this is the voice of God? Look at Samuel. He was called Samuel, Samuel. He didn't know who is calling him. He ran to Prophet Eli. He said, I did not call you. Go and sleep. The second time, the same thing. Go and sleep.
The third time, Eli told him, when you hear the voice, just say, Lord, here am I, I'm hearing. That is how Samuel became a prophet of the Most High. By the grace of God, you will hear a good voice from the Lord. You will hear the voices. If enemies are parading around to do anything against you, God will speak to you the way out of the old problem, and you'll be safe in Jesus' name. On September 15 this year, voice of the Lord is almost the same thing like how to hear from God. After hearing from God, you have to be able to determine that yes, this is the voice of the Lord. Psalm 29 by Pastor Sunday Body. By the grace of God, you will be able to differentiate the voices of evil when he's talking to you and the voice of God when God is talking to you. If a prophet is prophesying on your life, God says you must be able to discern the true understanding of the prophecies, and this will be a blessing, and God will give every one of us the spirit of discerning to know the voice of the Lord. On September 22 this year, making the right choices. Making the right choices. Psalm 101 verses 1 to 3 by Pastor Akintayo. Making the right choices. If you are planning to do anything, I've told some people, the first word you will hear is from God. And immediately, Satan will come in to discern it from you. You want to go to that way? You are already a failure. Then you started thinking, right, left, right, where will I go? That is the topic of that sermon. Making the right choices. God will direct you. If at any time you are in a short position in life, the voice of the Lord, you will hear it and you'll be able to make the right choices. On September 29, spiritual death. Romans 6, 14 by Pastor Onifade during the morning service. Our father died a spiritual death in the Garden of Eden. That is why we lost the glory God has given to them that passes to us. God comes in the morning, early in the morning, as you are doing early morning prayer. God will come to them in the morning. And before they go back to sleep in the evening, God again will come to them. But on the day they lost the glory, they disobeyed God, they did not see God as they have seen it again. That is a spiritual death. God will save you not to have any spiritual death in Jesus' name. On October 6th, God of Sufficiency, 2 Kings 4, that is by me, about a widow that became a millionaire. And God will make you a millionaire in your way. Now, when we say millionaire, the general understanding of people is that in your bank account, you will have millions of dollars or millions of naira. Like our leaders in Nigeria are just taking all this money to Switzerland, to America, to UK. They call themselves millionaire. They will be poor in the end because it is not the sweat that they are just gathering together. It is the sweat of other men. You see, in the church of God, you say, Owo alata, Owo oniru, enikeni, toba muna, unshekwe funra eni. Owo alata, Owo oniru, enikeni, toba muna, unshekwe funra eni. Oluwa yogba wa, kulinu, idamu ayeji. On October 13, testimony and prayer by a pastor from Nigeria. This pastor is a good friend of Pastor Yemi Ayeni. He gave us his life story, how from a street boy, he became a leader of the youth. And when he got married, For good 12 years, the wife was not pregnant. He did all he could until he came to see the hand of God through Papa Biara, and he has three children at a time. That was his greatest evidence before us here. He took about 1 hour on that day during the service to give us the testimony. In Jesus' name, you have a good testimony. Amen. Finally, let me use this. Eyes of God by Papa himself. Let somebody read Jeremiah 16:17. Jeremiah 16:17. My eyes are on all their ways. They are not hidden from me, nor are their sins concealed in my eyes. There is no sin that is concealed before God. Àwọn Yorùbá máa ń sọ pé ní babaláwo tó yí tó borí tó lọ́lọ́run ò rí mu tó lẹ́nìyàn ò rí mu bẹ́ẹ̀yàn ò bá rí ọlọ́run máa ń rí ni pé ohun gbogbo tá a bá ń ṣe ọlọ́run rí wa. Ẹ jẹ́ ká ṣe òtítọ́ ká sì ṣe rere torí pé rere ló pé láàrin ìsọjí tá à ń ṣe ìwọ́ tó ládùúrà ògbà. Wọ́n ní kó bọ́ síta kó jẹ́kẹ́rẹ́ kó fún ẹ ní ìpè gẹ́gẹ́ bíi mustardi kó wá òbú ti ṣe máa rí lára ẹ̀ ní agbára ọlọ́run ayé ò ní gbé iṣẹ́ pè. Gbogbo ọlọ́run a mọ̀ tàn nínú ayé yín. Ojú ọlọ́run òun wo olúkúlùkù wa. Ohunkóhun tá a bá dáwọ́lé láti máa ṣe ẹ jẹ́ ká ṣe bó ti ṣe tọ́ àti bó ti ṣe yẹ. Èyí ló mú ẹsẹ̀ ọ̀rọ̀ wa wá tó ní come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Ẹ̀yin ènìyàn mi nínú ti Olúwa, I'm trying to implore every one of you today to focus his or her mind backward critically in all areas of his or her Christian life in relation to the word. That is the word of God and teachings on the word of God. Just place a measuring scale on your table. Now, in front of any court, you will see what I'm saying. You see an angel, he holds sword and a scale. In that scale has two containers in your own mind. That is why the eyes of the Lord is seeing us. Put your goodness in one. Put your bad thing you have done. When you are talking of your neighbor or your brother or your friend in evil, put it in one. And when you are thinking of goodness for your neighbors, for your friends, for everybody, put it in one. And see which one will weigh. I pray that your goodness will overweigh the evil ones. That is how we can measure our life. Kò sí ẹni tí ó ń purọ́ fún yàn tí ó mọ̀ pé rọ́ ló ń pa. Ẹni tó ń purọ́ fún lè mọ́ gbà ó lè mọ́ pé rọ́ ló pa o. Just as we had the other day. Okay, let me give you a simple sample. Professor Oyawoye, people who attended Ibadan University, we know him. He's a geologist, the first geologist in Nigeria. He said one day, a friend of his, when they were trying to go to the library to go and study, he said, he's having stomach trouble. He said, you are having stomach trouble? Okay, let me pray for you. Instead of prayer, he started cursing him. When you do this, but this man was saying, amen, amen. At the end of the prayer, the stomach went away. The stomach went away because the faith of that man is on the prayer that what is troubling me, it will go. And eventually, he didn't see anything like that again. That is how we end the problem of stomach. So, think very well. Whatever you are doing, with your fellow person, friends, neighbors, in your office place, and anywhere you are. God will be with you. The Bible says, if you say we have no sins, we are deceiving ourselves. But God is faithful, who doesn't want any sinner to perish, but to repent and be saved. In those days in Nigeria, I don't know whether it is the same thing in America because I did not attend any school here. If the examination is drawing nearer, let's say this is now December, you will have your final examination either in February. Your lecturer or tutors will start revising all the past subjects you have taught in the school. You call it revision exercises. Any student who devoted his time to listen to the revision exercises will never fail that examination, because all the questions that the teacher will bring to you on examination day will be brought under revision. That is how all the sermons we had that I enumerated above. Think on them, review them. Which side do you think you need to adjust yourself? Which side do you think you want to amend your ways of life with your fellow people and neighbors? And God will be with you in Jesus' name. We are trying to review our Christian life and determine any area we need to amend our ways of life to meet the standard of God demanded from us. And in Jesus' name, God will give us the way to turn a new leaf, because nobody is 100% clean. Nobody on earth is 100% clean. Therefore, we must, by all standard, try as much as possible to walk with the Lord. As we are preparing to enter into the new year, we should ensure that we drop any shortcomings and walk with the fear of the Lord, as his eyes are all our ways. Hebrews 12, verses 1 and 2. Hebrews 12, verses 1 and 2. So, then, let us run the race that is laid out in front of us, since we have such a great cloud of witness surrounding us. Let's throw off any extra packages. Get rid of the sins that trip us up and fix our eyes on Jesus, faith pioneer and perfecter. He endured the cross, ignoring the shame for the sake of the joy that was laid out in front of him, and sat down at the right side of God on the throne. By the grace of God, you will gain the right side of God at the end of our lives. As a guide to walk perfectly with God, let us quickly consider the book of Psalm 15. It has a very short verses. If you are able to walk according to these verses in the Bible, in this very psalm, I am sure you will be perfect. Even though when you score 90% in an exam or 95%, what have you done? You have already passed the examination. And by the grace of God, all of you will pass the examination. So what are the major points? There are about 11 points in this psalm. 11 points in this psalm. You must be blameless. You must be righteous. You must always speak the truth. And your tongue must not utter slander against anybody. You do not do any wrong to your neighbor. And do not cast slur or insult on others. One who despairs a vain person, honor those who fear the Lord. One who keeps an oath, even when it oughts. But when she praise and worship or what Sister Evangelist Ogoyemi did. He make reference. If you make any promise to God, at the time you want to fulfill that very promise, what will come your way will make it very difficult for you to fulfill the promise. Okay, for example, this question of 10%. If anybody make 100 million and to bring in 10% of that 100 million, don't let us deceive ourselves. When you look at it, you forget about 10 million. It is that 10%, how heavy it is, it will come to your mind. So, that is what God is telling us here. When you make a promise, no matter how it will hurt you, you have to fulfill it. 10. Somebody who lends money to the poor without interest. If I'm in need and I come to you, this is my problem. All I need now is only about $250. If you can help me, I will try to pay you back within few days or few months. If you have the money, give it to me or her. Don't add any interest. Àwọn tá ń pè ní agbowó àwọn tó máa ń gbowó èlé kó ló wa kó ṣọ́ wa nínú gbogbo nǹkan wọ̀nyí. Last on Psalm 15, he who does not accept a bribe against an innocent man. If you are able to guard yourself against all these 11 points in Psalm 115, I'm betting you, you will be a perfect man before God. Because Paul has said it, I am not perfect. I am aiming at perfection. And God will take us to that level in Jesus' name. Galatians 5:22-24. But the fruit of the Spirit is love. You will say you love your friend or your neighbor or anybody. And if that man or that lady has offended you, you started cursing him or her. There's nothing you not said against her. The question of love will be forgotten. But the love of God is very strong. So we must love under any circumstances of our need. Then joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faith, meekness and self-control. Against us there is no law. If you are able to guard yourself against all this, you love, you have joy, you have peace with your neighbors, you are patient if any crisis comes, and you are kindness to the poor. You are kindness to the poor or to widows or all those people who you discover they are in problem. For example, the word of the Lord teaches us that you must bless these anointed men of God. But you'll be looking at them, they are working, they have their money, why should I bless them? The word of God says you should not look of what they have, but to do the right thing to bless them. Then God in turn will do what? He bless you. In Jesus' name, you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Moses, the leader of the Israelites, who led the Israelites out from Egypt, from bondage, revealed the journey of 40 years in the book of Deuteronomy. That is why you have to be able to reveal your past yourself and see where you stand. Know the area of your shortcoming and how you will amend your ways to be perfect. He told the Israelites to remember what God did before Pharaoh, what God did to them while they were in the wilderness, when they were thirsty, when they were hungry, and many other things. And at times, they offended God that God said if he destroyed them. Moses plead before God and God forgive and he did not destroy them. He reminded them all this trouble, but he told them, do you know it is because of you God did not allow me to enter into the promised land, even though he allowed me to go up to the mountain and see how beautiful is the promised land. God said, you will not enter there. By the name of the Lord, you will enter into the promised land. Whatever we debar you not to enter into the promised land, you will never go near it in Jesus' name. What did Moses did? They need water. And God just told Moses, just stretch your staff to the rock and water will flow. But Moses, what did he did? He strike on the rock and water actually came. But God said, for you have done this, you will see the land, but you will not enter there. And Moses did not enter into the promised land. He handed over to Joshua, who led the Israelites to the promised land. In Jesus' name, whatever will come your way, to be so annoyed. That is why the Yoruba people, even the Bible says, ma se je ki orun ko wo ba ibinu re. Binu, sugbon ma se se. Mi o le so fe anybody pe ko ma ja o. Eja. Tori pe te ba ja, e le mo wara yin. Nipa ija, e mo wara yin. Ki ba se aja, ka diju. Tori pe te ba diju te ba nja. O rere t'Olorun fe mu wa ba yin. E mo ni mo pa to ma koja. So idite yan fi nja ki se pe ka di ota ara wa ṣugbọn ka fi mọ iwa ara wa ija o dola oruko lo nba nda so ni oruko e nikan ni ilu wa niyan ki se oruko e o ṣugbọn oni won fi n pe ati gbogbo awon me titi di wakati owo yi ija o dola oruko lo nda so ni eyin ni Olorun e je ka duro ninu imo Olorun ka si rin gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìfẹ́ rẹ̀ nínú ìwé Deuteronomy 28:1-13 Mose súre fún àwọn ọmọ Israeli gbogbo wa lámọ̀ ìre yẹn pọ̀ lórúkọ Jésù ní agbára ẹ̀jẹ̀ ọ̀dọ́ àgùntàn gbogbo ìre tí Mose tó sún fún àwọn ọmọ Israeli ní ọjọ́ náà nínú ìwé Deuteronomy 28:1-13 gbogbo ẹ̀ pátápátá ló máa ṣe mọ́ ẹ lórí nínú àwọn ère náà wàá kàn ká díẹ̀ fún ẹ nínú ẹ̀ ni ó ní and it shall come to pass if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe and to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations on earth. That is the first blessing. Then he said further, and all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. Blessed thou be in the city, and blessed thou shalt be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruits of your body, and the fruits of thy ground, and the fruits of thy cattle, and the increase of thy cane, and the flock of thy sheep. Go home and read. Those are the blessings. And the blessings is going from one generation to another generation in the Israelites until today. Israelites, they are stubborn. But God did not remove the promise he made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob until today. God will not remove the blessing he has already endowed in your life. If you sin, either knowingly or not knowingly, the good promise of God will come to pass in your life in Jesus' name. But we must be obedient. Failure to be obedient leads to so many evil things. Not all the people who left Egypt got to the promised land. Only Caleb got to the promised land. Those who rebelled against Moses, they were all perished in the wilderness. You recollect when Miriam and others stood against Moses, Moses called them to one part, and he stood in one part. Then he called on God. If I am faithful, I am your servant. Today, let this judgment come down. Let this land that these people are standing opened and consume them. And it happens. All of them were consumed on that day. You will not be consumed in Jesus' name. God will be with every one of us. The book of Hebrew is another important revision of the old Bible by Paul. It was Paul who revealed both the New and the Old Testament. If you read Hebrew 11, he speaks about faith. If you read Hebrew 13, he speaks about acts of sacrifice and our relationship between ourselves. God will teach us the way to know the truth, what we'll be doing to the God, to our Lord, and to our neighbors. Finally, brethren, I congratulate you once again for seeing today's service. Very, very important. Àwọn Yorùbá sọ wípé ní ẹni tó bẹ̀rẹ̀ iṣẹ́ kọ́ ló ṣe o, bí kò ṣe tó ṣe dópin, Olúwa yóò fún un ní ẹ̀mí gbígbà àti àlàáfíà. A ti wọnú ọkọ̀ yìí ná 2014 lágbára Ọlọ́run pẹ̀lú ayọ̀ làá fi parí ẹ̀. Ẹ̀bẹ̀ kan ni wọ́n wá fẹ́ bẹ̀yìn lónìí, ẹ̀yin ènìyàn mi nípa ti Olúwa. Ẹ jọ̀wọ́ mo bẹ̀ ní orúkọ Jésù. Mo rò pé mi ò lè wá sílé ẹnikẹ́ni nínú yín, bí mo tiẹ̀ ń kọjá, mo wá yá ilé yín, kí wá fún mi ní $1 tàbí $2. Tẹ́ ẹ bá fún mi ní nǹkan kan, ẹ fún mi ní $20. Ẹ̀bẹ̀ tí mo fẹ́ bẹ̀yìn, kó lọ kó tẹ́wọ́ gbà kẹ́ sì gbárò. Àwọn ohun tí a ń ṣe nínú ìjọ yìí, a ń ṣe ètò ìdámẹ́wàá. Ìyẹn jẹ́ ìpinnu lọ́kàn àti Ọlọ́run. Kò kan àlùfáà, kò kan anybody. That is why tó fi sọ fún wa pé ẹjà mi ló lè, ìwọ tó bá jọ Ọlọ́run ló lè, ó ti wà níbẹ̀ fún ẹ, kì í ṣe pé ẹnìkan ló ṣe máa sọ fún ẹ. Ìwọ tó bá dẹ̀ jọ Ọlọ́run ló lè, ìbùkún yẹn ti wà níbẹ̀. Tí wọ́n bá ní kẹ́ dá ìdámẹ́wàá, ẹ̀tọ́ yẹ kó dá bóyá $20 tó dá $5, wọ́n á bless ẹ̀. Blessing yẹn, òun kọ́ ló important, bí kò ṣe blessing tí Ọlọ́run ti fún àwọn tó ń dá ìdámẹ́wàá yẹn dédé. Ó ti fún wọn ní blessing yẹn, kò lè yẹ. Ìwọ tó bá ti ṣe, Olúwa yóò ràn ẹ́ lọ́wọ́ láti máa ṣe. Ìkejì ni pé Thanksgiving tí a máa ń ṣe, mo bẹ̀ ní orúkọ Ọlọ́run àti Titan offering wa. Ẹ má dá wọ́n naira mọ́, wọ́n wọ́n ní dollar mọ́ ẹ̀dùn. Mo bẹ̀ ní orúkọ Ọlọ́run, ẹ jù bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ. Olúwa yóò gbé ń ga ní ọdún tá a fẹ́ wọ̀ yìí. Olúwa yóò gbé ń ga ní ọdún tá a fẹ́ wọ̀ yìí. Ẹ jẹ́ kó máa bẹ̀rẹ̀ lórí $2. Ẹ bá mú wá ní $1 kó jẹ́ méjì. Ẹ má mú $1 wá síwájú Ọlọ́run. Orin tọ́lọ́run ṣe fún yín ojú $1 lọ. Ẹ pé wọ́n máa ń sọ pé ní àṣà wọ́n ní ìjàbú ní bùrẹ́ mi èmi náà yóò bùrẹ́. Ohun tó bá ṣe fún Ọlọ́run, Ọlọ́run yóò ṣe padà fún ọ. Ní 2000 tí mo délẹ̀ yìí, mo convert $1. Mo rí pé almost 100 naira ló jẹ́ ní Nàìjíríà. Mo ní lágbára Ọlọ́run nínú ìjọ yìí o, mi ò ní bá wọn dá $1. Mi ò ní bá wọn dá $1. Ní Nàìjíríà 50 naira ni mo máa ń dá. Mo ní mi tó bá ń dá 50 naira máa dá wá 100 naira. Bí mo ṣe ń dá nìyẹn tó dẹ̀ ń jù bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ títí di òní. Ẹ jọ mo bẹ́yìn ni mo ṣe sọ pé túlá gẹ́gẹ́ bí Paul ti ṣe sọ. Ó ní ìmọ̀ràn tèmi ni mo mú wá fún yín, kì í ṣe gẹ́gẹ́ bí Ọlọ́run ti pa láṣẹ. Ẹ jẹ́ kí $1 kó dópin nínú ayé yín, torí pé Ọlọ́run dá yín lọ́lá jù bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ. Ọlọ́run sì máa gbé yín débi tó ga. Ọlọ́run máa gbé yín débi tó ga. Ẹ máa wọ new level. A lè ṣiṣẹ́ láti day one dé 30 days. Òun kọ́ ló mẹ́ta o. Ìbùkún Ọlọ́run ló mú ní ìlà tí kì í fi làálàá sí i. Ní orúkọ Jésù, ẹ gbárò. 2014 kó jẹ́ ọdún tuntun nínú ètò ìdáwó ìjọ yìí. Káwá ohun tí Ọlọ́run yóò ṣe fún yín. Àwọn tí ò sí bí ẹ jẹ́ kí wọ́n mọ̀ pé kò sí ẹni tí ò ju $1 lọ Olúwa yóò gbé yín ga o. Ẹ ní Daniel lórúkọ Jésù. Ẹ jẹ́ ká dìde. Ẹ sọ fún Ọlọ́run. Lẹ́yìn ìgbà tí ẹ bá dúpẹ́, ìpinnu yín nínú ọdún 2014 kó fún yín okun àti agbára láti múṣẹ àdúrà. Ní orúkọ Jésù Olúwa wa, ẹ sọ fún Ọlọ́run, bí ẹ ti fi ayọ̀ parí ọjọ́ ìsinmi tó kẹ́yìn nínú ọdún yìí, tẹ́ sì ti fi ayọ̀ wọ inú ọdún tuntun náà. Lẹ́yìn ìgbà tí Jésù ò báyìí tí ì dé, gbogbo ore pátápátá tó wà nínú ọdún 2014 kó lè wa kó fi dá yín lọ́lá àdúrà. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Lord, I thank you for everything you are doing on this mountain. Your word has been spoken. Let it be manifested in our lives, O Lord. Bless all your children on this mountain. Those who are supposed to be here, but for one reason or the other, they are unable to be here. Let this blessing be unto them. And for all those who have traveled home, Lord, be with all of them. What they have gone to do, let them do it perfectly well. And at the time they are coming back, let them return back to this church with goodness and in good health. Lord, we thank you for everything you are doing for us. As we continue in this vineyard, do not leave us unattended to. Keep us day and night, and let your eyes follow us throughout the way of our life. In Jesus' name I pray. I say Happy New Year to everyone, because this is the last Sunday of the year.